Moonring is like my dad. Mysterious, unexpectedly brutal, and refuses to hold my hand. There's been much ado recently about the price bump games are going through at the moment, but you know even the best AAA games will be a dollar on Steam eventually. At the end of the day, the price of video games is like Grindr, a race to the bottom. But why wait?
Get it.
But why wait? Some of the best games ever made have been free. Spelunky, Cave Story, Dwarf Fortress, conning old people with crypto. Now, we might have a new game entering that canon, Moonring. Developed by Dean Carter, the co-creator of Fable, Moonring is a deep turn-based RPG with a handcrafted open world and procedurally generated dungeons. Its influences stretch back to Ultima, a series that is so much of its DNA in your favorite games that it's been court-ordered to pay child support. When asked why he made the game free, Carter responded, "Life is hard, COVID sucked, everyone's poor and stressed, and I don't need the $300 that this would make me. I'd rather take the goodwill," which is in New Zealand what we call a good cunt move. Well, we don't say cunt on this channel.
You can say the C word.
Okay.
The other countries Christians don't like it.
I'm sorry, dude, but you fucking played yourself. This game could have made you at least $1,000 if you had monetized it. The Steam reviews are all positive and many demand the right to buy the game. Personally, I respect his choice and will be paying him in what every intern gets paid at a mid-sized business. Minimal exposure. The main screen at first blush looks like a fucking mess, but it's really just a scare off the weak-willed, just like Elden Ring's stats sheets. Reading these stats makes me feel like I'm auditing a wizard for tax evasion. There's an entire desert between each of these numbers. The game efficiently on-ramps you and sets you on your way with a general quest that is quickly forgotten, as is customary. I'd show you, but this game has no save scumming. You need to live with your decisions, which is my primary design gripe with real life. Moonring eschews leveling and XP grinding in favor of milestone goals. You don't get experience from doing the same thing over and over again. You get experience from experiencing things. This makes the moments of choosing your build feel monumental and precious, rather than a small reward for putting in the hours. Milestones are associated to the gods. Hitting one of their milestones immediately gives you stat buffs in their respective domain, and points to spend in their specific skill pancake. I mean, it's a pancake, right? It's not a skill tree. It's they're all right there. It's a skill chode, really.
You can't say chode either.
What? Committing yourself to a single god gives you a casting discount, but also applies restrictions on how you play. For example, one god blinds you, while another forbids you from backing out of a fight. This reflects real life, where committing yourself to the Abrahamic god limits your ability for premarital sex. The game has the zesty flavour of discovery about it, which apparently comes with every dark neon game with scanline effects these days. Dialogue can be done by typing to NPCs, which gives even the mere act of interacting the hint of unknown possibilities. Don't go expecting robust dialogue though. If you go off the beaten track with the conversation, they're most likely going to respond the same way my friends do when talking about games exactly like this one. Dungeons are the primary roguelike aspect of the game. Once you delve, you are locked in the dungeon till you find the end goal key. Failing the dungeon by accidentally going to heaven sends you straight back to the entrance to try again. Re-entering re-rolls the layout so you can't trial and error your way to a perfect run. Since this game is levelless, a lot of survival comes down to just being smart with your kit, knowing how each enemy acts, and always being willing to just be a little bitch and run away. Pro tip, learn how to sneak better. Hide in tall grass. Be just like a Pokemon. And by that I mean just be a literal axe murderer. The game rewards offensiveness with skill recharging. Attacking is done by bumping into people and taking evasive maneuvers when they break through your poise. Poise is like their temporary hit points, which recharge after a couple of turns of not getting smacked around. I haven't gone back to double check it's called poise, but that's what it's called now, as far as I'm concerned. This makes the turn-based combat an actual dance of giving ground and doing damage, rather than just standing there and brute forcing it all. The writing has a good sense of humor, which contrasts with how foreboding the world is. But the lore itself is as mechanically involved in your life as it is text on an item. It's a world that you'll want to learn every part of. The questing relies on you being of sound body and mind to be able to complete, which makes it completely unplayable by the average American president. So sometimes you'll fall out of the groove of following the clues to the next place, but I mean that's fine because at this point, this is a world I live in, hunting wildlife and just exploring arcane ruins. I'm role-playing silently in my head. This is a world you can chill out in, and having a world you can chill out in for free is maybe the best kind. This is a good chance to ask you all to like and subscribe. I mean, you could do it if you want.
You should like, comment, and subscribe. This is me pulling your finger. You just farted.
What?